name is Connor Banks, and I am one of the electronics engineers for Orient Express Racing Team. I always wanted to be a professional sailor, and I left university with that goal in mind for a year and a half. But then I felt like I wanted to do a bit more with my degree, a bit more on the shore side. So I kind of broke away from the full-time sailing and went back into marine electronics. Having the sailing background and the electronics background works really, really well because you can bring all your sailing knowledge to electronics. Electronics is important because it controls many, many parts of the yacht. The electronics really starts from the sailor, goes all the way through the yacht to controlling movement, providing power, and then even, you know, giving us the chance to pull that information off the yacht. So it's really integrated into these yachts. If we don't have any electronics or batteries on board, then things don't move very well. So the cutboats are totally different. So for example, in the previous edition of the Ocean Race, we had the Amokas, which were round the world racing yachts. They had to last maximum, I think the longest leg we had was about 40 days. Whereas for the cutboats, they have to last maybe, you know, 10 minutes or 20 minutes on the race course. So compared to doing long offshore boats where they have to last months and months to a race boat that has to last 20 minutes, it's a totally different world. It's like rally car driving and F1. They both have similarities, but they're also totally different in many aspects. We are working closely with the sailors to try and get all of their feedback to give them the best chance they have to do well out in the water. But then also, you know, we're working closely with the data people, with all the designers, to try and give them the information they need. So we kind of fit a whole large role where we're not necessarily just maintainers of the boat, we're also working closely with other departments to achieve that end goal. So in the electronics team, we have David, who's the head of the department. Then we have Alex, who's more running the AC40 side. And we also then have Gilles, who's going to be a technician for us. And then we have myself and Tom, who are embedded systems. So we kind of work with electronics, but also the software side. In the software side, we have mechatronics, which is Céline Le Berre. And she's fully within all the coding side. We work with her daily.
Je m'appelle Céline Le Berre et donc je suis ingénieure mécatronique au sein de l'Orient Express Racing Team. J'ai commencé par un bac généraliste avec une option technique, mécanique et électronique. Et ensuite, je suis partie sur une école d'ingénieur à Rennes, une SAD Rennes, pour une prépa généraliste de 2 ans et après un cursus en électronique et informatique industrielle. En fait, je travaille sur des systèmes embarqués, que ce soit dans la téléphonie mobile, dans la robotique industrielle, dans des drones sous-marins. Mon rôle consiste à travailler sur toute la logique du système pour le pilotage des voiles, des foils et également toute la gestion d'énergie à bord. La mécatronique au sein de ce projet, en fait, est assez importante parce que sans la mécatronique, sans la HMI justement, on n'a aucun pilotage du bateau. Donc en fait, c'est un peu comme si dans une voiture, on n'avait pas de volant finalement. La HMI, c'est l'interface homme-machine. En fait, c'est tous les boutons et les écrans et ce qui permet à l'utilisateur, donc au navigateur, d'avoir les informations du système et de piloter en fait son bateau. On travaille vraiment tous main dans la main. On se connaît et on peut compter les uns sur les autres. Et ça, je pense que c'est primordial pour pouvoir aller de l'avant. Je pense qu'il y a vraiment une grande complicité, même si l'équipe est jeune, on a réussi à former un bon groupe avec une ambiance de travail qui est bonne. C'est ça notre force.
We're quite a young team, so everyone is super motivated to try and bring everything they have to the racing we are going to be doing. For us, I see the cup going really positively. It's our first time as a team doing this, and I think a lot of the people in this team, it's their first time as well. So we're a really young team, but we're super ambitious. Everyone here wants to try and do our best to lift that cup at the end of the day. So who knows? Watch this space, I guess.